A plane passenger recorded a UFO as his plane was flying over Lake Michigan, Grand Rapids area in October 2021. The object, which was white and cylindrical, had no features, no wings, no windows, no tail, no exhaust, no flight surfaces. This video showing a UFO close to the Tic Tac UFO model or to a cylindrical UFO clearly echoes many older UFO observations. But in all of these observations, the same question remains unresolved. What could it be?
Section 51.
Hi everyone, what's up guys? DOZgeek here with Section 51. Big thanks for your support to the channel as always and for watching this video. Before starting, it's still the time to hit that like button and to share this new video right now. Share all our videos to keep supporting Section 51. Push all indicators to the top for the channel Section 51 and watch our videos until the end. Leave your comments and bring the Section 51 community to life now more than ever. Now, if you are ready, let's start right now. Some fresh UFO news today. On October the 17th, 2021, during a flight from Boston, Massachusetts to Denver, Colorado, a plane passenger recorded a UFO as his plane was flying over Lake Michigan, Grand Rapids area. The passenger recorded the object for about 1 minute before it disappeared from sight on its eastward cruising path. It did seem to change elevation or speed. The object, which was white and cylindrical, had no features, no wings, no windows, no tail, no exhaust, no flight surfaces. So, did the passenger accidentally film a so-called Tic Tac UFO? Last year, when the Pentagon initially confirmed the leaked UAP incidents were indeed encounters with unidentified objects, the witnesses involved in the sightings went from the fringe to the mainstream. And maybe this new UFO sighting is another one coming now in the long list of Tic Tac UFOs witnessed during air flights in the sky of USA. I think that when watching this video, if you consider the aircraft's speed and the distance being covered by the object, you can realize that it is moving much faster than the aircraft it was being observed from. So I don't think it could be a balloon or something like that. And moreover, I don't think this video was manipulated. This video showing a UFO close to the Tic Tac UFO model or to a cylindrical UFO clearly echoes an older UFO observation in Italy. Indeed, on June 18, 1979, at 11:30 a.m, pilot Giancarlo Cecconi was returning to Treviso, AFB, Italy, in his G-91R fighter with his G-91R Group 14 of the Air Force's 2nd Fighter Wing, after completing a reconnaissance mission when he photographed a very strange phenomenon. In fact, that's the Istrana radar center that first registered the intruder's presence on its radar screens and instructed Cecconi to approach an unidentified aircraft that entered the restricted area. With unused film in the cameras of his aircraft, the pilot activated the cameras and approached the UFO at a distance of 70 to 80 meters and at a speed estimated at 300 knots, around 500 kilometers per hour. Airport ground staff watched the event through binoculars. Cecconi was called in by the Treviso control tower to warn him that the object was emitting a strange blue trail. He pursued the object at an altitude of 7,000 feet, but did not notice its trace. When the pilot approached the object, he moved up and down at an altitude of 1,000 feet at a time, climbing up to 13,000 feet, which is a behavior very similar to the one of the Tic Tac UFO. Ciccone flew 7 to 8 flights near the object and each time photographed the UFO with a camera, resulting in 82 frames in which the intruder was captured. The visible UFO was stationary relative to the G91, but the radar center confirmed to Ciccone that it was moving. Its course and speed were determined. The pilot saw a matte black cylindrical object and the presence of a small white or transparent dome located on the upper side of a slightly flattened object. The dome was similar in shape to those found on sports cars. While Ciccone was making another call to return to another series of photographs, Istrana's radar called and reported that the object had suddenly disappeared from their radars. Seconds later, Treviso's control tower confirmed that the UFO had visually disappeared. A few minutes later, the plane landed, the films were removed and quickly developed. The object was a cylindrical object no less than 8 meters, around 26 feet, long and no more than 3 in diameter, flying 13,000 feet in the sky. The incident is significant thanks to the camera footage, radar and visual evidence from several witnesses, including a highly respected fighter pilot. Was it a cylindrical balloon for military testing? I don't think so, because the pilot and the Air Force base would have been informed of its presence and its purpose. Moreover, a weapons test balloon or even a weather balloon is unable to make such movements in altitude at such high speeds. However, this amazing UFO encounter remains today an incredible observation and a concrete case, a true reference in the study of all these unexplained phenomena in the field of ufology. What could be the real purpose, the mission of these cylindrical UFOs? If they are inhabited, how many occupants are there? Are they equipped with weapons? What technology allows them to move so easily in the air? Do they have extraterrestrial or human origins? Where are they from? All these questions, I'm sure that many people have been asking them for several decades, even hundreds of years. I hope you enjoyed this video. Please allow me to remind you that Section 51 is on social networks, Facebook, Instagram, Twitter. Don't forget to hit that like button and that bell button too. Don't forget to share the video and to subscribe to Section 51. Thank you. This was DOZgeek with Section 51. I'll be back really soon. Open your eyes, watch the sky, live long and prosper.